In the last video, we said that we were going to work through the design of a database for a photo sharing application. And I showed you this diagram right here. So I'm saying that we should probably make a database that has four different tables inside of it. A list of users, a list of photos, a list of comments, and a list of likes. Just to be clear on what likes are right here, if you've ever used an application where you could maybe upvote some kind of post or like a photo, that's what this likes table is all about. It is for implementing some kind of liking feature inside of a photo sharing app. So your first question here might be, how did we come up with this design? How did I come up with these four different tables? Well, let's walk through a couple of tips that I have for you on building your own database designs. All right, so a couple of quick notes here. What tables should we make for any particular application? The first thing I want to say is that a lot of times for any app you build, chances are it's going to have a lot of features inside of it that are common amongst many other web applications. There are many features out in the world, like let's say user authentication, some kind of liking system, some kind of commenting or discussion system that many different web applications implement. And to that end, there are tons and tons of resources online to give you suggestions on how to structure your database to implement these very common systems. Let's say, for example, that you are trying to build some kind of like system. You want to have the ability for your users to like images or maybe posts or something like that. If that was the case, your first resource, if you want to figure out some table design, would be a very simple Google search. For example, you could go over to Google and do a search for something like SQL schema, like, or maybe upvote system. And then immediately you're going to see tons and tons of resources online for how you might structure some kind of database to include some kind of upvoting or liking system. So anytime that you are building an application that has some feature inside of it that probably some other application in the world has, your number one resource is Google, and you're going to see a lot of discussion about how you might implement that. Now, of course, at some point in time, you might not be building some kind of very original application, and it might have some kind of feature inside of it that no one has ever built before. So what do you do at that point? Well, at that point in time, I would encourage you to maybe take a look at some mockups for your application. Maybe do you have some kind of mockups or preliminary design on what the user interface looks like? What is the purpose of your app? Our goal here is to try to identify the different kinds of resources that exist inside of your app. And as a first step, kind of a preliminary design, you might try to create a separate table for each of those different features or each of those different resources. Then for each of those different resources, you might try to find some kind of relationship or ownership between those different resources. Now, these three items here that I put in this diagram, I can lecture all day, but my words that I'm sharing right now don't really give you a lot of knowledge. You know, they're not really effective. You really just have to see this in action. So let's do that right away. I'm going to take a look at two screenshots out of the Instagram mobile application, which is also a photo sharing app. And I'm going to show you the process that I might go through to build some kind of database design for something like Instagram. So in this first screenshot right here from the Instagram mobile application, and by the way, I'm just going to assume that you are passingly familiar with what Instagram is and what it's all about, we can see that this is a user profile page. The user in this case is Instagram. It turns out that the Instagram company has their own Instagram account. Who would have guessed, right? So this is a profile page for a very particular user who signed up to this application. This is the profile for them, and we can see information about this user. Right away, I can identify that this user has a username. In this case, it is simply Instagram. This user also has some kind of biography right here, something that is just a little quick bit of text that describes this person. I can also immediately identify that a user has the ability to follow other people and has the ability to be followed. That immediately starts to indicate that there's some kind of relationship between different users. Users can follow each other. So that implies that there is some kind of relationship there. Then at the bottom of this page, I can see that there is a list of photos. Because there is a list of photos right here, this kind of indicates that there is a resource or maybe a table of photos that are stored in some kind of database. The other thing I want to point out here is that these are photos that are tied or owned or were posted by this very particular user. So that indicates that a user somehow owns or has a direct relationship to a number of different photos that are stored inside the database. Okay, let's take a look at one other screenshot, and then we're going to take all this knowledge and condense it down to some kind of preliminary design. So this is a screenshot for a singular photo, or singular post, as it's called inside of Instagram. So from this screenshot, I can very easily identify that there is some kind of comments resource down here. So there's presumably somewhere in some database stored a list of comments. The comments that are posted here are posted by very particular users. That indicates that there is some kind of relationship between comments and users. And the comments that are listed here are comments that are specifically intended for this photo or this post. These comments are for this post and not some other random post that's stored inside the database. That indicates that not only is there some kind of relationship between these comments and users, but there might also be some kind of relationship between these comments and this post as well. And then finally, it appears that users can like a photo or like a post in this case. So once again, that would indicate that first off, there is some kind of list of likes or some kind of like resource, and that there is some kind of relationship between a user and a like and a photo. All right, so from these two screenshots, we were able to kind of discern different types of resources that might exist inside this app and the fact that there's some kind of relationship between them. Now, the last thing I want to do very quickly, because I know this is a long video, we've established that there are these four different resources in this application. We've also established that a user somehow creates and owns different photos. We've established that a user somehow creates and owns comments. And we've established that users somehow own and create likes. In addition, we've established that there's some kind of relationship between photos and likes, because you can like a photo, and that photos and comments are somehow also related, because you can add some comment to a photo. So we can see right away by just drawing these lines, and never mind what the directional lines really mean or anything like that, we can see right away that there's some kind of relationship between records in each of these tables, and that somehow they are expressing either just a plain relationship or some kind of ownership of sorts. Okay, so now that we've come up with some idea of how to approach the design of a database, let's take this one step further in the next video.